Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. I am today so proud of you guys. We finished together our A1 grammar full course. This is the last video today. So basically, I gave you all the knowledge you need to know how to master the A1 German grammar. Of course, we will continue on this channel with vocabulary and comprehension. You will see this next week. Please like and subscribe. I will continue with the A2 grammar full course, like I promised, when I reach 1,000 subscribers. So today we have, as I told you, the last topic, which is how to connect two sentences. I will talk about it in a second. If you're not familiar with the normal structure of a sentence, with the subject, the verb, the object, and in what order should be the time information, the local information, you can watch my videos. For example, here the sentence building video, but I also have more information on my channel. You can just check out the different topics there. And then you can come back and keep watching, of course. So, before we talk about the topic, we need to get a common ground about the technical calling of some things. A German sentence has a main part. This is called Hauptsatz. Hauptsatz has two words here. Haupt, which is main, and der Satz is the sentence. So, der Hauptsatz is the main sentence. This is how I will call it. Sometimes I might say the German version, Hauptsatz, but we know from now on and also for my next videos that we mean the main sentence. Then we have Nebensatz. I think you can guess what it means. We have Neben by itself, meaning next to, and of course, again, the sentence, which makes it the sentence next to the main sentence. Nebensatz. Those are the terminologies of those two things. Today we will talk about connecting main sentences. We don't need this part so much, but in the near future we will. So keep it in mind if you want to stay here and learning with this channel. So we want to connect two main sentences. We have many options. The first one is the most typical one, which is and. Und. We need this for counting informations. For example, Sandra ist Studentin. Sie wohnt in Wien. Sandra is a student. She lives in Vienna. And now we can say, Sandra ist Studentin, comma or not if you want, und sie wohnt in München. Or we can say, Sandra ist Studentin und wohnt in München. As you can see, the rule here is that the second sentence, the second main sentence, because they're both main sentences, also has a subject, and this makes a comma possible if you want. But if the subject is the same, you can cut it off here. We don't need it twice, and this doesn't make a comma necessary. Next one is oder. Oder is the typical A or B, giving an alternative. So let's see the two sentences. Clara muss den Bus erreichen. Dann kommt sie nicht zu spät. Clara must reach or get the bus. Then she will not come too late. Now we have the first option. Clara muss den Bus erreichen. Komma or not komma, oder sie kommt zu spät. Same thing here. If the subject is the same in both sentences, you can leave it and you have the choice if you want to put the comma or not, if you have the second time the same subject. And if you cut the subject completely out of it, you don't have to put the comma. It's even better not to do it. It's the correct way because we only have one subject here, and the comma would make a big break into the meaning. So, Clara erreicht den Bus oder kommt zu spät. Clara gets the bus or comes too late. Of course, I don't have to tell you that you need by time to decide if it's logical to use und or oder. Next one is aber. Aber makes it an opposite. Let's see. Max hat heute viel Zeit. Früher hatte er immer Stress. Max today has a lot of time. In the past he had a lot of stress. Two opposite things and we can combine it. Max hat heute viel Zeit, aber früher hatte er immer Stress. And here you see we don't have the option of putting or not putting the subject again. So we have the subject here and we have the subject here. And of course we have the comma. We don't have any option to leave it out now in this case. Another way to use the aber is for something that is holding us back. For example, ich kann dich besuchen. Heute habe ich keine Zeit. I can visit you. Today I don't have time. We can see there is something giving a boundary. So let's do the same. Again, we know we need the subject in both sentences and we need the comma. So we can build it. Ich kann dich besuchen, Komma, aber heute habe ich keine Zeit. So we can see the second main sentence is giving the boundary or the bad news, if you want, of the first sentence. So the first sentence cannot happen, so to speak. This is how you use it. Do not feel confused about the order of the sentences. We have other varieties for giving emphasis and other things, but learn it like this now and later you will see what you can put in front and what not, because many mistakes happen because people try to put the verb, to put other informations on positions where they don't belong. Next one is sondern. Sondern means like instead. It's like correcting something. It's not A, but it is B instead. So the second main sentence corrects the negative first sentence. Let's read. Paul wohnt nicht in Köln. Er wohnt in Bonn. Paul does not live in Cologne. He lives in Bonn. Here we have Paul wohnt nicht in Köln. Komma is mandatory. You have to. Sondern, you can say the subject again if you want and the verb. Er wohnt in Bonn. He doesn't live there, but he lives there. Same as in English, you can say he doesn't live there, but there. You know? The last one is giving a reason using denn. Denn gives a reason, so we can translate it with because of something. So the second sentence, which has the denn, is always giving the reason why the first sentence is happening. So let's read. Eva läuft zur Bushaltestelle. Der Bus kommt in 2 Minuten. Eva walks to the bus station. The bus comes in 2 minutes. They make it a little different here. Sorry about that, but let's read it. Eva läuft zur Bushaltestelle, comma mandatory, denn der Bus kommt schon. The bus is already coming. You can also say, der Bus kommt in 2 Minuten. Yeah, you can exchange that. It doesn't matter so much. So Eva walks to the station because the bus is coming. If we check out the position of the words, which are really important in my opinion, you can see you have the subject, then the verb and everything else. And the connection words we learned today have the position 0 in this case. This means position 1 will stay the same, the subject, and then we have the verb. So sometimes you know that, for example, in questions, if you put information in front of a main sentence, the verb comes in the beginning. But this is something else. I'll give you an example. If you have it here on the right side, jeden Morgen spielt sie Tennis. Every morning she plays tennis. Now you have an information, an additional thing in the beginning. This is where you have to exchange the verb and the subject position. This has nothing to do with the connection words. They are not counted as something that switches the positions around. This is why they have also this zero, so to speak. They don't have any influence on the position of the sentence. There are some others that do, but not those ones. I think the best way to learn something is with an exercise. So we do the first one together and then you can try by yourself if you want. Sie fliegen nicht nach Kreta. Ihre Mutter liegt im Krankenhaus. They don't fly to Kreta. Their mother is in the hospital. So we go back and we see, okay, what do we need now? Is it like counting stuff? Is it an alternative? Is it an opposite? Is it instead? Or is it a reason? I think not going to vacation because your mother is in the hospital would be the last one, a reason. Of course, later when you can talk better, you can say we're not going to vacation and our mother is in the hospital and we don't get our money back, you know? You have other ways to use the language, of course. But for now, we have the last one. Sie fliegen nicht nach Kreta, denn ihre Mutter liegt im Krankenhaus. In this case, the subject is not the same. You cannot substitute it, you cannot leave it out. Because we have sie, they, and ihre Mutter, their or her mother. It's not the same. You cannot leave anything out here. And you have to put the comma, of course. So you can press pause and try the other examples if you want. Okay, let's compare. Keep in mind, sometimes we have the option to leave something out to make it sound more natural. Paul fährt nicht zu Klaus, sondern zu Maria. Ich möchte dich einladen, aber du hast keine Zeit. Lisa besucht mich vielleicht am Montag oder am Dienstag. Werner ist Journalist und arbeitet bei einer Tageszeitung. Maria bestellt keinen Wein, sondern Bier. Wir gehen nicht ins Kino, sondern ins Theater. Those are the versions I chose. Please keep in mind two things. Sometimes the comma is optional and it looks better to not use it, like here and here. But there are some other versions where you have to put it and you just need to follow the table on that. And the second thing, try not to substitute too much because sometimes we cannot. Only if the subject is the same. For example, Paul fährt, er fährt. Subject and verb is the same meaning. Ich möchte and du hast is not the same. We cannot leave anything out. Lisa besucht. Besucht. And here you can see really nice. We have another word here and the position changes. Do you see it? We have the verb on position one and the subject on position two. Only because we put the maybe in front. Those are little details. I always tell my students to pay attention. And if they do it, they get better much quicker. Just saying. So here we can leave the second part out. Because it's the same. Werner and Werner is the same. The verb is not the same, but it doesn't have to be in this case because he is and works. Maria bestellt, or sie bestellt, is the same. Wir gehen and wir gehen is also the same. We can cut it off in the second part, but we don't have to. We can use it also like this. Wir gehen nicht ins Kino, sondern wir gehen ins Theater. It's totally valid. Not really natural, but it's okay. And the last session of our full course, A1 Grammar, will be putting the words in, the ones that we just learned. Example, Beispiel. Heute bleibe ich zu Hause, aber morgen will ich ins Theater gehen. Today I stay home, but tomorrow I want to go to the theater. And here we see again really nice, because of the morgen, the position changes also between the subject and the verb. if we would say it like this, just for additional information, heute bleibe ich zu Hause, aber ich will ins Theater gehen. Today I stay home, but I want to go to the theater. Everything completely changes the meaning, but also the position between subject and verb in the second part of the sentence. Just saying. So, put in the right little word and then we will compare. Let's compare. Ich kann dich nicht besuchen, denn ich muss noch arbeiten. Du kannst wählen. Wir können ins Kino oder ins Theater gehen. Paul kocht oft für seine Freunde, denn er ist ein sehr guter Koch. Wir möchten in Urlaub fahren, aber wir haben kein Geld. Sie können die Rechnung bar bezahlen oder sie bezahlen mit einem Scheck. Did you do everything right? If you have questions, leave it in the comments below. I'm always really happy when I see a question or a feedback. And I answer almost immediately if I have the time. This is it for today. And this is it with our segment. I can't believe it. Thank you so much for your support. Please like, subscribe, share the channel with other German learners. You can help each other. You can follow me on Instagram if you want. I have at least two other projects in mind for A1. So see you next week then. Thank you. Bye.